エコです。今日はとっても楽しみにしていたジョン・ウェストさんに来ていただきました。ウィニー、ウィニーアピスさんが
write it on paper,
right.
And I keep it. And then if I hear music that reminds me of that story, and I can bring the story out. And I'm almost halfway done with that one.
For your, you mean
yeah,
song?
Because the lyrics are there in front of me now, because I've already sort of written them down in the past, and I save these notebooks for the lyrics. And then if something comes along musically, then I'm like, oh, that's that, then I put it together.
So you're writing songs and the lyrics together, mm-hmm. that's for your solo material?
For any reason, I just write because I never know what's going to come up next.
Right, right.
If I think of a cool concept or a cool title or just a chorus or something, I'll like record it to my phone or write it down.
Yes.
And I have like a catalog of stuff. So if somebody says, "Hey, I'm working on something,"
wow.
I want you to listen to the music, and I say, "Okay, I like it, and it reminds me of this," and then I'll go back and or maybe just have a new idea.
So you're always ready for new things. Okay, so I'd like to ask you about your music too, but that's the heavy metal thing I really love. I'm so glad you're back to heavy metal actually with this. Atlantica?
Di
Giorgio. Yeah. And you did a melody most of all. Melody and the lyrics?
Yeah, not the lyrics, melody.
You already had it in your catalog when you started?
Yeah, some of the ideas I already have, but some comes from just hearing the music.
Oh,
or maybe
so
Roger had an idea. Sometimes Roger says, like, I think about this title, this angle. He had a love song on there that he had written the lyrics to.
Yes.
So I kind of reworked it with my melody.
Okay.
Just make it fit differently so it sounds like me singing it. Just depends.
I love it.
So many different ways.
Yes, I love it when you don't forget your, you know, that voice.
You gotta have that.
Yes, you have to have it.
Yeah.
I like the people.
Yeah, you'll hear a lot of that tonight.
Yes.
You know, I have a place here and there where I can be.
Yeah, that's
even though,
great.
You know, Dio never did that. Never went to this register.
So you put your signature to it?
Where it makes sense.
Yes, where it makes sense.
Dio was one of my influences, but I never learned that style of high singing until I heard like Ian Gillan, Rob Halford, Glenn Hughes.
Mm-hmm.
This scream was not Dio's thing at all.
You self-taught? You start as a drummer.
Yeah, but I taught myself how to sing. Vinyl.
Oh, yes.
With the record on.
Yes. Do you remember which album was the first one you got?
My first album was probably like Elvis.
Elvis. Okay.
From my mother's.
Oh, okay.
The first Boston album, I think, was the first real rock record. It was like rock and guitars and high singing.
Yes.
Brad
Delp
and all those harmonies. Like, that first Boston record was like, all right, that's what I'm going to do.
Yes.
So you'll hear some of that, you know, in Artension, my soul stuff.
Yes.
That sort of like that first Boston record influence. Even though it doesn't sound like Boston, but somehow the seed is planted there.
Well, Artension's going to be 20 years anniversary soon.
It's like 96.
Yeah, so next year, 20 years.
Okay.
So,
I believe
are you going to do something?
Yeah, we should.
You should.
Yeah, we should make a new
and
record.
You should go to Japan.
Yeah, we should go to Japan.
You actually, you went.
And, some of us
should. Okay.
But Vitaly calls me and he wants to do another one, but it's just, you know, our schedule is
right. Right, you've
make
been busy.
The time. You have to really make the time.
That's true.
He's busy and I'm busy, so it's like,
you've been busy.
We have to set aside the time and focus on it and make it happen.
Yeah.
We both want to do it.
Mm-hmm.
It takes time.
Well, I have some questions from Japanese fans. You ready?
I'm ready, yes.
Okay.
Do I have an option to say next question?
No.
I have to answer each one?
Yes.
Okay.
But I'll make it short. So you?
I love the Japanese fans, so I would do it.
Can you explain how so?
I love this feeling of respect when you play.
Mm-hmm.
And people are not talking.
Right.
And they're not videotaping.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a real live experience where you can play. play the song.
Yes.
And they're respectful of that moment. You perform better this way. And even though when I first started going to Japan, everybody was looking at their phones.
Really?
Walking around. Yeah, we didn't have the cell phones.
Oh.
Yeah, they all had them, you know, wearing around the back. But when they got to the concert, it wasn't, they weren't listening. You could actually hear a pin drop. They did a slow song. It's like, oh wow, this is great.
Was it like
this
a royal man? Far
yeah,
away?
Yeah, when I first went there, it was so, the first time I played live.
Yes. So you have...
Not far away, though. Just follow me.
Follow me! Yes, that was for...
We did the fear.
Oh yeah, yeah, I was lying. Yes. Oh, good song.
Going back to that.
Yes. Yeah. Oh yeah, follow me. Oh, where are you going?
Follow me. Oh, I don't know where I'm going.
That's my treasure.
Don't go something new.
Wow, don't
follow me. There's no other.
You should do this.
Should we do that?
Yeah. Well, so you you had a project and also Artension Royal Hunt. All the albums you sang, you have special one you have in your mind, like memory.
They're all special. It's like children.
I knew that, but I had to ask.
Just because the one kid's got red hair doesn't mean you don't love the kid.
Right.
You know, just love
it. All right, so all the good stuff. And you sang for Cozy Power last album. Do you have any episode?
Any
actually, you episode. You were actually recording with him in the same
studio. Yeah, we recorded.
Oh.
He was there when I was recording my vocals.
Okay.
He did his drums in Wales. Mm-hmm. He liked to record in
a
big room in Wales. Yes, he liked his drums out there. So.
I see.
We never actually saw him recording those tracks, but we would hear the tracks.
So
they would come back and then I would sing to them. He would be in the studio. And,
so you're nervous singing for him right there?
Yeah. It was pretty nerve-wracking. And Neil Murray was there too. So you've got this rhythm section that's like the legendary.
Wow.
And he really was my favorite drummer.
Mm-hmm.
Like, that was my rock.
Yes,
yeah. So it took some getting over. No, he was just a regular guy, and he would always tell me, like, you know, you're my favorite singer.
Yes, I agree.
I love how you sing. I was like, is this really happening? Like,
yes.
He's sung, I mean, he's played with, you know, a list of the greats, who's who singers, and I was like, he would be like, you're in my top five. It started out, like, you're in my top five, and then, like, a year would go by, you're, like, in my top two. And then call me, like I would record another track or something. I heard the new track. You're the best singer I've ever played with. It's just like, this can't be happening. And then, of course, he wrecks his car and dies before we get to lay out. So, you know, mixed emotion. Tragedy strikes.
I'm so happy that, you know, you are so. Your talent is so recognized by all the talented people. We get to see that, you know, we get to hear
it. It's a cool part of it, definitely.
Yes.
You know, we were doing a festival when I was in Royal Hunt. We were in Italy.
Mm-hmm.
In Rome, and I was in the same hotel. Glenn Hughes was there.
Oh.
And we used to have the same manager, and he knew my material.
Oh, my God, right.
He heard the Artension stuff at the Royal Hunt. And he calls my room.
Oh.
That's good. Would you like to have tea?
Okay,
so we're going to have tea.
Are you a tea guy or a coffee guy?
I love tea. And coffee. Anything.
Even
caffeine.
Yeah.
So we have tea and he proceeds to explain to me how he, in his opinion, that myself and Bjorn Land are the two best singers to come out of the decade of the 90s. The two best rock singers.
Oh, nothing.
Like,
yes.
Like, this is not happening either, right? When I first met him, I was like, I'm such a huge fan of you.
Mm-hmm.
The very first time I ever met him. And he, All he said was, ditto.
Ditto?
Like means, I am of you.
Oh.
And I thought, how does he know who I am? How in the world does Glenn Hughes know who I am? Like, he already had known what I was doing.
Sure. You know, so yeah, well known.
Probably like 98. Uli's my favorite guitar player. He's so good. And
So he found you, right?
Well,
for Uli. Uli is that?
Sort of like roundabout way. Yeah, I heard that he really liked my voice, so
yes.
I sent an email saying, I'm a huge fan. I'm more than ready. I already know the songs.
Yes.
You know? So then I got an email back, and it took a couple of years.
It's good timing.
Yeah. Oh, last year we did the extreme guitar tour as well.
Hi.
I sang for him. He got along great. He likes how I approach the songs.
Yes.
It's very appropriate to that. Mm-hmm. Young Klaus, the way I deliver is like that.
Mm-hmm.
I really try to get that magic into those songs. He likes that. So
magic.
He likes my look. He's not about like skulls.
Oh.
Metal. He's like, he likes that I wear like deer skin,
feathers,
and,
yes.
and you know, he loves that.
That's
so I was
right.
like, this
yeah,
is
such
perfect.
A match. I saw the picture. That's a great match.
Yeah. The music's a match, the magic is there, and we just get along.
Yes, that's so, very, you can, yeah, because the audience catch that,
yeah.
those aura.
Yeah. He's got a really cool sense of humor.
You do
he,
too.
We understand each other.
That's right.
He steals my liquor. I know who's taking it. Because in the morning the bottle's half empty.
Oh,
I know
no.
who did it, Roth. I'm coming for you.
Yeah, so we are really hoping that you come to Japan. Because Uli just
yeah.
came last year.
I know, and he wanted me to go.
Yes, I was
couldn't
surprised.
Make it happen. Nathan ended up doing it. So.
Right, not now.
I would have done it.
Why?
I'm available.
You. Yes. Well, I have to let you go.
Okay.
It was such a nice
yes,
meeting
nice
you.
Too.
My dream came
Thank
true.
You. For keeping metal alive.
Hey, and I'd like to have a message for Japanese fans.
Japanese fans, I'm coming back to see you hopefully in the spring with Uli Jon Roth. You're going to hear me do the Tokyo tapes the way I do it.